As we see here, this is the atrial action potential graph. The blue line represents the normal action potential and the black line represents action potential under the influence of an aberrant pulse which is occurring at this time instant. Similarly, this graph shows the atrial action potential where the aberrant pulse is occurring at this time instant. So we can see that the two graphs where the aberrant pulses are occurring at two different time instances. Figure 3 and figure 4 represents a plot of frequency distribution of the above two action potentials. As it is seen, there is hardly any perceptible difference in the frequency spectrum so far magnitude is concerned. So abnormalities cannot be detected using the magnitude plot. Here, figure 5 and figure 6 show the phase plots of the two above action potentials. Here we can see a perceptible change which can be used to detect the abnormalities.
Similar patterns exist for ventricular tachycardia and their magnitude and phase plots have also been constituted. As mentioned in the original proposal, our proposed algorithm exploits this change in the phase profile for the detection of arrhythmia and also derives the time instant at which the anti-tachycardia pulses are to be applied. It is seen that the 200 bin channel frequency is sufficient for most cases.
The proposed algorithm plans to use a TI-MSP430 microcontroller with a low onboard memory, and it is extremely important to implement an algorithm that uses minimum power and minimum memory. As an optimal approach, the FFT weights kept stored as pre-calculated complex exponentials to provide angle and magnitude computations, which are kept into 1 into 200 arrays. The sampler continuously samples the signals at a specified rate of 200 samples per phase, and magnitude computations are done.
For the purpose of development, the action potentials are simulated using the OPPLRT, as the simulation requires an extremely small time step of the order of 10 microseconds, which is otherwise not possible in real time. This represents the far field or the shock wave sensed by the EGM. The EAPs have been simulated using the resources in physionate.org, and we have been able to access the data online using the TI-MSP430. The finite state machine or the FSM has been tested using the MATLAB state flow, and the phase changes can be detected for different arrhythmia.
With the present project, if we can detect the exact relative refractory period by utilizing this phase difference, then we can deliver the ATP at the appropriate juncture. So this is one big advantage. The next advantage is that we can utilize the same phase difference to discriminate between SVT and VT. Even the latest morphology discrimination, which is used for differentiating between SVT and VT, is not perfect. So if we utilize this phase difference, it will be an add-on algorithm over the present platform.